Okay, good afternoon, everyone. Thank you all for coming to our second quarter memorial service for our community. So at this memorial service, we are remembering those that have passed away between May, June, and July. And so we have four of our neighbors that we will be remembering today. And so I would like to start it off. I always like to start with a poem. Today's poem I'm going to read is by Maya Angelou called When Great Trees Fall. When great trees fall, rocks on distant hills shudder. Lions hunker down in tall grass, and even elephants lumber after safety. When great trees fall in forests, small things recoil into silence, their senses eroded beyond fear. When great souls die, the air around us becomes light, rare, sterile. We breathe briefly, our eyes briefly see with a hurtful clarity. Our memory suddenly sharpened, examine and gnaws on kind words. Unsaid promises walks, never taken. Great souls die and our realities bound to them take leave of us. Our souls depend upon their nurture, now shrink. Our minds formed and informed by their radiance falls away. We are not so much maddened as reduced to an unutterable ignorance of dark, cold caves. And when great souls die, after a period, peace blooms, slowly and always irregularly. Spaces fill with a kind of soothing electric vibration. Our senses restored, never to be the same, whisper to us. They existed, we can be and be better, for they existed. Maya Angelou. Okay, so we have, like I said, we had four neighbors in our community that have passed away in the past 3 months. So I'm going to share their name and light a candle in their honor. We'll have a moment of silence, and then afterwards, I would also like to read the name of our seven further away neighbors, but neighbors nevertheless that we lost in the Highland Park shooting. So extending our community just a little bit further. So the first member of the community that we lost this month was Robert Dunworth. James Davis. Ben Blumberg, and Nakuda Ahmed. Now, if we can just close our eyes, take a moment of silence to remember those neighbors. Thank you all. And now extending our doors a little bit more, the seven neighbors that we lost in the Highland Park shooting. Arena and Kevin McCarthy, Jackie Suddenheim, Catherine Goldstein, Eduardo Uvalado, Nicholas Toledo Zaragoza, and Stefan Strauss. So all people that we would like to remember. So for our four neighbors that we have lost and that we are remembering in our community, Robert, James, Ben, and Nakuda, does anybody have a memory or a story, anything anybody would like to say on any of those four? We need some pictures. Okay. Lorenia suggested some pictures next time, but. So, Jane?
Yes. I was a friend of Nakuda Ahmed, who was either 103 years old or 104, I'm not sure which. He was a general in the Pakistani army. And he and his wife lived through the partition of India after World War II when the British left and Pakistan was created and they moved to Pakistan. They had two daughters, both doctors. One was the head of anesthesiology at Northwestern. The other one is a radiologist. And Mary Helen is the widow surviving Nakuda. You know her. She lives in 31L. She herself is 94 years old. So if you could send a little note, I know she'd appreciate that very, very much. I remember Nakuda when you prayed to her. Thanks.
So Jane just shared some wonderful information about Nakuda Ahmed and how he was a general in the Pakistani army. And he, I will tell you, he did just turn 104 last Friday. So he celebrated his 104th birthday on Friday. And then soon after, he had lived his life. So thank you, Jane, for sharing those sweet memories. Does anybody else have any words they would like to say? Or if not, then I have a couple that I can say also. So borrowing from Kristen Milton, our director in marketing, she knew Robert Dunworth a lot better than I did. And so she told me a story about how when he first came to the Breakers, he pulled up to look at the community and he drove a bright yellow Jeep. And she was so shocked at this tall, tall man getting out of this bright yellow, canary yellow Jeep. And then we were talking about just memories about him. He was a more reserved person, very kind if you did talk to him. But if you ever went up to his door, he had this silly cartoon character on his door. And we were all trying to remember what it was from. And it, if you've seen the commercials, it is the Cinnamon Toast Crunch character. And those commercials where they're jumping into the bowl of milk, he had a giant Cinnamon Toast Crunch character on his door. And I can remember it vividly from all of our door deliveries we did through the years. And so he was just a wonderful man with a very silly sense of humor. And then next, James Davis. I'm sure many of you would know him if I did have a photo, so I'll work on that. But James Davis, he was just a wonderful, kind-hearted, loving man. His daughter was here often, and so he lived on the fourth floor, and he just always had a nice thing to say to everybody. No matter what was going on in his life, any health ailments or anything happening, he would always say good morning to every person in that lobby as he's waiting for a bus or heading out of the building. He would make sure to say hello to everybody, give them his famous smile. He was just a lovely, lovely man. And then the other member, Ben Blomberg. I'm guessing most of you do not know who he is. He actually moved into our community. He lived here about 2 weeks before he passed away. And so, nonetheless, even those 2 weeks he was a resident of the Breakers, was a wonderful, kind man, was meeting people in the dining room at dinner. And then it just came to be his time. So all four of these gentlemen that passed away, lovely, lovely people. Rana? I'm not quite sure. Rana asked if his sister had helped move Ben in. I'm not quite sure who moved him in, but...
Him.
Yes.
And he came on the train, and his sister lived here.
Yes.
His mm-hmm. sister lived at the Edgewater Beach apartment. I know it.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, she and her husband stayed here while they had some work done on their apartment. But anyway, so she brought her brother from New York by train over here. He was a professor, I think. And yes, he was here. And then they went back to New York by train for some other stuff. And then they came back. And then I saw her and asked her how her brother was. He said, he seemed very nice.
Yes. He was a very friendly, interesting man. So Rana had shared that she, when talking with Ben and his sister, that he moved here by train all the way from New York. So I'm sure we can all imagine that is quite the journey to get here by train. But nevertheless, we will all remember Robert, James, Ben, and Nakuda, and those seven lovely souls that were also lost in the Highland Park shooting. So if there are no other memories that you'd like to be told about our friends at the Breakers, I offer it up if anybody wants to remember anyone outside of the Breakers, any family or friends that have passed away, anybody else give a name. Marilyn?
I'd like to remember my brother who just died 2 weeks ago. And he lived in Arlington, Texas. We kept in touch a lot by phone. He's one of my four brothers. Mm-hmm. And they always called me the queen because I was the oldest. And then had four brothers underneath me, and he's the one right below me. But we were listening to some music the other day, and part of it was where the organist said, listen to this middle part, because it's like going to heaven. There was, you know, the music would change, and it felt like we were going to heaven. Mm-hmm. And I was so touched just at that concert at Loyola. So anyway, like we all do, we can envision and just feel when people are with you still. You know, their spirits are still there.
Yes. Thank you, Marilyn. We are so sorry for your loss.
Thank you.
Would anybody else like to say a name or remember anybody else? Okay, well then I would ask if you all would take a minute. We are going to sing Amazing Grace. So if you have your lyrics, we're going to sing it through. I'm going to get our music ready. And if you all would join me.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. Was blind, but now I see. Was blind, but now I see.
Okay, thank you all very much for coming again to our second quarter memorial service. We hold these about every 3 months to remember those in our community, so I appreciate you all helping me do that today. Thank you and have a good day.
Thank you.